Hi everyone, Susumi here, looking at the Rama map in Foldit, and I'm going to talk about how to correct a bad dot. This is a design puzzle I've been working on. I've been doing some mutating and wiggling, and I want to know if the position of the protein is realistic, because I want to know if it would really fold up the way I've predicted. And one way to assess that is to open up the Rama map and look at where the dots are. The Rama map is mostly white, but it has some colored areas, and each amino acid in the protein has a dot on the graph. And what you want is for all the dots to be in the colored areas. So I'm just going to click on some of these dots. Each time you click on a dot, you get the Rama map that's specific for that amino acid. So let's click on this one up here. This one is a serine, and serine has a lot of blue up here near the top, so this dot is in the colored area. So I know it's a realistic shape for that dot. What about these two down here? This one is an aspartate, and it has blue down here where the dot is, so this one is inside the colored area, so it's realistic. What about this one? This one is segment number one, and segment number one is always going to have its dot on the y-axis, on this vertical line. So it will often not be in a colored area, but because it's an end segment, you really don't have to worry about it. You can ignore the dot on the y-axis. And this one down here on the x-axis, this is segment number 80. I can see the number up here in the corner of the Rama map when I hover over it. That's the last segment in my protein, and the last one is always going to be somewhere on the x-axis, so it may not be in a colored area, but you don't have to worry about that. What about these ones down at the bottom? This one is a glycine, and glycine has some blue area of the graph right around where this dot is, so it's actually inside the colored area, so that's realistic. And this one is inside the blue, and this one is inside, just barely inside the edge of the blue there. I'm going to check these over here. This one's a glycine. Glycine has a very big green area, and this one is well within it, so that's realistic. This one is asparagine, and it's within the green area for asparagine, so it's realistic. And this one is also within the green. What about this dot? This is a glycine, and it's way out in the white part of the graph. Glycine has some yellow color up here, and it's got this big green area, but my dot is nowhere near those colored areas. So this is a very unrealistic position for this glycine to be in. And what it means is that the shape that the glycine has in my protein is unrealistic. So if the scientists were to put my protein through the Rosetta software and predict what shape it would take, Rosetta would not predict that this glycine would have this shape because it's unrealistic. And so the scientists would say, oh, Rosetta doesn't think this protein will fold up the way the player has predicted. So they're less likely to try making that protein in the lab. So how can we fix the fact that this dot is way out in the white area? The first thing I'm going to do is open the selection interface. If you don't usually use selection interface, I encourage you to use it when you're working on the Rama map, and then you can switch back to original when you want to use any of your other tools. Okay, when the selection interface is open, if I click on this dot, Foldit will highlight the segment in the protein that corresponds to that dot. So this is glycine number 41. This is the segment that has an unrealistic shape. And to try and make it more realistic, I want to move that dot into a colored area. I'm not going to make a huge move by dragging it all the way down there at once. I'm just going to move it a little bit by clicking on and dragging this dot a little bit towards the green, and then look and see what it does to my protein. It's taken half the protein, two sheets and a helix, and it's rotated them. Let me undo that and redo it, and undo it and redo it. You can see that it's rotating half the protein, the half that's divided by this glycine from the other half, and it's rotated it counterclockwise a little bit. So I want to fix that rotation. It's rotating it in the plane of the screen. So in order to fix the rotation, I want to find another segment that I can move that's approximately perpendicular to the plane that I want to rotate it back through. And in this case, the closest segment I can find is the neighbor of the glycine. This is a serine. When I click on the serine in selection interface, it highlights the serine. And it also highlights the dot in the Rama map that corresponds to that segment. It turns white, and it's this one way up here at the top of the blue area. And that's the closest segment I can find to being perpendicular to the plane of the screen. If you think of each segment like a bendy straw, when you move a dot in the Rama map, you are not bending and unbending the bendy straw. You are rotating the bendy straw like you're twirling it between your fingers. So if I were to twirl this segment a little bit along its length, that would rotate this half of the protein one way or the other. So let's see if I can do that by dragging the dot on the Rama map. It's way up at the top, so I'm going to try dragging it a little bit down, more into the blue area, and see what it does to the protein. Just move it a little bit. Okay, that did not rotate this half of the protein the way I wanted it to, so I'm going to undo that move. I also noticed the dot is way over towards the left, so I'm going to try dragging it a little bit to the right. And that actually rotated this half of the protein a little bit clockwise, which is exactly what I wanted. I'm going to drag it a little bit more to the right. Okay, even a little more. So that has corrected the rotation that I got by starting to fix this glycine up here. You can see I got my sheet bonds back. I'm going to go back to the glycine. I can click on it in selection interface, and it will highlight the dot in the Rama map. And I'm going to move that dot closer to the green area. Again, not a lot, just a little bit. And I see, again, it rotated that half of the protein a little bit counterclockwise. I want to fix that rotation, so I'm going to click on the neighboring segment again because it's perpendicular to the screen. And moving right helped before. I'm going to try that again. Even a little more. And again, I got back my sheet bonds because I corrected the rotation of this half of the protein. So I'm going to work back and forth between these two segments for a while. Moving this one closer to the green, using this one to correct for the change. Okay, so as I correct for the changes that I'm making to the glycine, now I've got it well into the green area, so I'm happy with that shape. But as I correct for it, I notice I'm getting the rotation I want. That is, I'm rotating that half of the protein back clockwise, but I'm no longer getting pretty sheet bonds in there. And that's because in addition to rotating it through the plane of the screen, I've also rotated it a bit through this perpendicular plane. So you can see these sheets have pulled a little bit to the right of their neighboring sheets, and I'm not getting the pretty sheet bonds. But I think my bands are going to be able to correct for that. Another problem that I've introduced is that these helixes are overlapping with each other now. So that's a problem that needs to be corrected. I'm going to do some shaking and wiggling. And if I were to just shake and wiggle this protein as it is, it would probably move my glycine dot back up into the white area where I pulled it from. And I don't want that, so I want to freeze that glycine on the protein. Now when I click on its dot, it says segment is locked. And because I've frozen the shape of this glycine, that means this dot cannot move in the Rama map. It can't move out of the green area. The placement of the dot on the map matches the shape of the segment in the protein. So if the shape can't change, the dot can't change. Okay, and I'm going to do some shaking and wiggling. Since this is selection interface, I have to first click on the background to deselect everything. And we'll get some shaking going. The reason I have such a low score is because I've got clashing between these two helixes. So when I do my wiggling, I'm going to want to start with low clashing importance so that the thing doesn't fly apart. But I already have bands on my sheets, and I've got a few bands holding the helixes to the sheets, protecting my core filter bonus, so I'm not too worried about it flying apart. Okay, let me lower the clashing importance, maybe down to 10, and get a wiggle started. Flies apart a little bit, but the bands are going to bring it back. And once my score looks good, I'll go back to the clashing importance I was working at. Right now I'm working at clashing importance 5. It's early in the game, and I want to preserve my flexibility. Okay, this dot in the Rama map is the one that we moved into the green area. And because this glycine is frozen, this dot is not moving at all. The other dots on the map are moving during the wiggle. They're accommodating the change that I locked in on this dot as they try and reform the protein. I don't want to click on this dot during the wiggle all because that would select just the glycine, and then the wiggle wouldn't be wiggling the whole protein anymore. It would just be wiggling the glycine, which is frozen, so it wouldn't be doing any good. So I'm not going to click on the map while I'm doing a wiggle all or a shake all. Okay, I've got my sheet bonds back. I'm going to stop this wiggle a little early. And then I would unfreeze this glycine and do another shake and wiggle to make sure that I've locked in my changes. So let me click on the glycine. The glycine is still in exactly the same place that we left it because it was frozen during the wiggle. It's now in the green area. Let me just check some of these other dots. This one's in the blue. These look like they're out of the blue, but when I click on them, I see that they're in the blue. What about this one down here? So this is a serine. Serine has just a tiny bit of blue right here, so it's technically in the blue, but I might want to move it into a darker blue area. And this graph wraps, so if I wanted to move down more into the blue, moving down past this edge of the graph is the same as moving down into this top part of the graph. I can't drag this dot down because of the edge of the graph, but this place up here in the top is where a small move down would put it, so I'm actually going to drag it up. Actually, let me see what's highlighted. Okay, this down here is the highlighted segment, so that's the serine that corresponds to that dot. So I want to move this down a tiny bit, which is the same as moving it up a whole lot. Right, whoops, I lost my grip. Okay, so I've moved it straight up to near the edge of the graph. And now it's in a darker blue area, and what I can see is I'm going to undo that, redo it, undo it, redo it. You can see that this helix and this sheet are rotating about the serine. Let's see, it doesn't seem to be highlighted at the moment. About the serine that we moved. So again, I would look for a segment. They're rotating through the plane of the screen, so I would look for a nearby segment that is perpendicular to the screen. This neighbor right here looks promising. And I would try to rotate them back a little bit counterclockwise. Let's see if we can do that. Does up make it better? Up might make it better. I'm going to try undoing that. What about left? Left does not make it better. Okay, I'm going to go with moving it up a little bit. And it's pulled out of the plane of the sheet, so I would play around with this dot or some other neighboring dots to see if I could move it back into the plane of the sheet. So that's moved it into the plane, but it's kind of far away. So I would play around with the neighboring dots and just see if I could get those sheets a little closer together. And then I would freeze the one that I was trying to correct, that's this serine up here. I would freeze the serine so it can't move in the Rama map and do some shaking and wiggling to let the bands bring my protein back together, just like we did when we were correcting the glycine up here. So that's how you can use the Rama map to make your protein more realistic. A realistic protein will have all of its dots, except for the two end dots, in a colored area of the graph. And you can drag the dot on the graph to move it into a colored area. You want to do it in little bits, and then find a neighboring segment that's perpendicular to the plane that you want to rotate through to try and compensate for the movement of the segment that you're correcting. Okay, that's it for today, and thanks everyone for watching.